הדף נון תת הגמרא starts on the bottom of נון חית עמוד ב. הגמרא says בא מינה, this is the wrong מסכת, בא מינה בא מינה רבי חייא בר יוסף משמואל. Rabbi Chiya bar Yosef asked the question from Shemuel. Good morning. Kohen Gadol shekadesh et haketana ubagra tachtav mahu. So if you look in the next Mishnah, Nun Tet Amud Aleph, the Gemara says, V'lo yisa ta bogeret, Rabbi Eliezer v'Rabbi Shimon machshirim. Lo yisa ta bogeret. The Kohen Gadol, according to Rabbi Meir, is not allowed to marry a bogeret. A bogeret is a girl who is 6 months past maturity. Maturity is 12, basically, when she brings simanim. 6 months past that, she becomes a bogeret. Why not? The Gemara is going to explain that as she becomes a bogeret, the betulim, some of the betulim goes away. As she starts to have damnida, the damnida causes a rupture in the betulim. And she doesn't have betulim shelemim. She doesn't have a full betulim. And we'll see the machloket later if a kohen gadol needs betulim shelimim. So even though nothing happened to her, but because an older girl generally doesn't have betulim shelimim, and that starts at bagrut, a kohen gadol is not allowed to marry bogeret. So now, ma mineh Rabbi Chiya bar Yosef mishemuel. Kohen gadol, he was a kohen gadol when he made the kiddushin. Shekadesh et haketana, he married a ketana. Ubagra tachtav. And he was slow to make the nisuin, and she became a bogeret. Mahu, is he allowed to marry her? Rashi, ubagra tachtav, the last Rashi on the page before. Ubagra tachtav vime erusim. The kohen gadol asur bebogeret kedamrina bematniti, like we say in the mitzvah, mishnah. Umitzvato, his mitzvah is to marry beketana or benahara, either a ketana or a nahara. Mahu, Rashi. Is he allowed to marry her? Since my kiddushin, right, the start of my marriage was when she was a na'ara. Oh no. Batar nisu'in azlinan or batar erusin azlinan. Do we follow the nisu'in? Do we follow when she's moving into him? That's when she becomes. Everybody agrees that a kohen gadol doesn't have to change his wife every few months. Once he's married, he's allowed to stay married. So when does she start being considered married to him? Consider that she doesn't need what's it called? He doesn't need to divorce her. Do we follow the fact that he read, or did he have to make the nisuin to move in with her first? Amar lei, he told him, Tenituha, we learned in the Mishnah, Nit armelu on it garshu mina nisuin pisulin, mina erusin kesherot, pisulin kesherot. If a kohen gadol married a almana, if he only made erusin, she's still kishera. If he made nisuin, she's pesula, right? Alma we see, right? Period. Rashi min erusin kishera. So Rashi says alma the pisul kehuna batar nisuin azlin, and you see that the pisulim of kehuna follows nisuin. Not the erusin. Midelo pasil almana shenetarsa lekohen gadol umet. Right? You see that we're not posil almana who had erusin with the kohen gadol. Let's say the kohen gadol died before he made the erusin. We wouldn't say she's pesula. So you see that the psul of kohanim marriages is really by nisuin. So to over here, she shouldn't be considered married until she made the nisuin, and therefore you should have to get rid of her. Amar lei, so Rav Chiya bar Yosef told him, l'shavuye halala lo kami bayali debi'ahi demishavye halala. So I'm not talking about that she should be a halala. Of course, becoming a halala is going to depend on nisuin, whether he had nisuin or not. The bi'ahi the mishavya halala, the bi'ah makes a halala. Ki kami bayali, my question is, vehu isha biftuleha yikah. When it says he has to marry a bitula, Right? So once he has the kiha, lechaura, he's allowed to stay married to her. My kiha, my, what kiha is that? Kiha the kiddushin bainan? And therefore, once he made erusin, is good. Or kiha the nisuin bainan? Well, he has to actually bring her into his house like nisuin. Because after that, he's going to be okay. Says the Gemara, Amar le, hai nami tenituha. That's also a braita. Ire seta almana. If he made erusin to a widow, v'nitmana liot kohen gadol, so he made erusin, he's engaged. All of a sudden, the old kohen gadol died, and they elected him to be kohen gadol. Yichnos, he can marry her. So you see that since he already has kiddushin, he's allowed to go forward, even though a kohen gadol is not allowed to marry almana. Says Gemara, Shani Hatam Dichtiv Yikach Isha. It says over there, it says Isha. It says Vihu. Almana Ugrusha Vahalala Zonat Elalu Yikach. Kiyim Betula Me'amav Yikach Isha. Could have said Kiyim Betula Me'amav Yikach. Yikach Isha, as a wife, is extra. What's it coming for? Rashi. Shani hatam dechtiv Isha. Ki im betula me'amav yikach Isha. Ve'hai Isha kirai yetera hu. Umine from there marbinan lekaman bepirkin. Demires almana v'nitmana liyot kohen gadol yichnos. That extra word Isha is coming to add a woman that he's allowed to marry hidush. What's the Hiddush? Even though she's almana, since he made the Erusin before, he's allowed to marry her. Says the Gemara, okay, so let's say the same thing by Bogeret. Hachanami. Yikach, Isha is an extra word. It's not Yikach Isha, it's from Isha. Isha is marbe, that he's allowed to marry a woman that I would have thought that he can't marry. What's that? That even though he made Erusin, and now he became Kohen Gadol, he's allowed to continue.
Why would he think that he's not allowed to continue? Because he became Kohen Gadol?
Now he became Kohen Gadol. I'm starting the marriage.
He started the marriage.
I only made Erusin. Maybe Nisuin I can't start.
No, she's Horashov.
So let's use the same pasuk isha to say if you married her when she was a almana, when she was a bitula, and then she became a bogeret, but since you started, it's okay. So he says, "Ahat v'lo yikach isha, ahat v'lo shtaim." I'm only being marbe one type of woman, not a second type of woman. So he says, "Umara ita." So if you're only adding one, why are you adding almana and not betula? The opposite. Add betula and not almana. Says the Gemara, "Hai ishtani gufa, hai lo ishtani gufa." By the kohen gadol, by the betula, she's not the same woman that you got engaged to. You got engaged to her; she was a betula shelema. Now her body changed; she became a bogeret. It's a different story. Mashenk and Almana stayed the same. So therefore, it's easier to be marbe Almana with the lady stayed the same than to be marbe bogeret with the lady changed. Look in Rashi. Hai ishtani gufa bogeret nishtana gufa mena erusin le nisuin. Something changed. Almana lo nishtanit, she didn't change. Tosafot comments. Hai ishtane gufa kodem nisuin ahar shenet mana liyot kohen gadol. Fuadin. The same thing would apply. Im ires bogeret o ketana ubagra veharkach nitmana liot kohen gadol. So let's say he got engaged to a nice 14-year-old who's a bogeret, and then they made him kohen gadol. Says that's okay. It's lo ishtani gufa.
Lower to higher.
She's the same. He changed. That's like almana. Nitmana li yokon gadol. She's staying the same. The davka nitmana. The problem is only when he's kohen gadol, v'harkach bagra, and then she got changes. Who de lo yichnos? The nishtane aguf ahar she nitmana. V'tzarich iyun im ahar she nitmana naasid mukat etz o be'ula. He have nishtane aguf lo yichnos o lo. Let's say he was engaged to her. Is that considered nishtane gufa? Only bagra, which is like a halachic change. V'ktzat mashma beperek kama de kedushin de lo hashiva be'ula ishtari gufa. De ka'amar itchilat bi'ah kona. If you hold at the beginning of the bi'ah is kone, we had that question before. Is ha'ara kone or not? Yachol kohen gadol lekadesh bebi'ah. The kohen gadol can make kedushin bebi'ah. Ve'i chashuv ke'ishtani gufa. If you say that the bi'ah is like changing the guf, hey achichnos, how's he going to marry her? After the kedushin, she became a be'ula. Ve'alo be'ula hi b'sha'a nisu'in. Im tomar, if you're going to hold the bi'ah irusin osa. Umihu on the other side, ve'perek elu na'arot chashiv be'ula shinu yaguf. Ka'behad parich adraba betula. Betula legezira shava shara ani kore ba naara shelo ora. So mishani ha ishtani gufa halo ishtani gufa. So you see over there betula is ishtani gufa. So Tosfot's not sure. Okay. Mishnah says kohen gadol lo yisa almana. Kohen gadol can't marry almana. That's pashut. It's a pasuk. Ben almana mena erusin, ben almana mena nesuin. Here's the chidush that almana applies even mena erusin, even though she never moved in with her, you never slept with her, nothing. She's a betula, but she's an almana. Velo yisa et habogeret. He's not allowed to marry a bogeret, meaning a girl who's 6 months past naarut. Rabbi Eliezer and Rabbi Shimon machshirim bebogeret. Rabbi Eliezer and Rabbi Shimon are machshir by a bogeret. Velo yisat mukat etz. He can't marry a woman whose betulim were knocked out mechanically. Okay, says Gemara. Tanu Rabbanan. Almana lo yikah. When it says almana lo yikah, ben almana mina erusim, ben almana mina nesuim. Whether it's from the erusim, whether it's from the nesuim. Pshita, simple. Mao de tema leilif almana almanami tamar. Let's learn from Tamar. Right, it says by Tamar, Shevi almana bet avich. And she was already nisua to Peretz and Eren Onan. Heavy Ashloki Darka, but what's the difference? They were nisuin, they were living in the same house. Right? Right? Mao de tema leilaf almana almana mitamar mala la minisuin afka minisuin kamash malan ve'ema hachinami ema hachinami. Maybe it's the same. So he says dumya de girusha. Why shouldn't we learn from almana dumya de girusha? Why? Because it says almana girusha. Ma girusha ben minisuin ben mena erusim. Just like a girusha is nisuin and erusin. Why? Look in Rashi. Pshita almana stama mashma. Mitamar shevi almana. Dumya de grusha. O begrusha pshita lei. Why? The stama hi de letlan lemelef. There's no other. Where are you going to learn grusha from? I don't have a pasuk for that. So grusha for sure is going to be ben mena erusin ben erusin, because there's no limiting factor. Now that it says almana o grusha. So almana is like Yerusha, just like Yerusha is ben men erusin, ben nesuin. So to almana is ben men erusin, ben men nesuin. Right? Dumya de Yerusha, be Yerusha. Okay, good. Says Gemara, af almana ben men erusin, ben nesuin. Velo yisata bogeret, he can't marry bogeret. Tanu Rabanan, vehu isha bivtuleha yikach. He should marry an isha bivtuleha. It's a lot of extra over there. Could say who isha betula yikah, right? What is a biftuleha with her betulim? Yikah prat lebogeret shekalu la betuleha, as opposed to a bogeret whose betulim is going down. Rashi, betula, ihave ketiv betula yikach. I would say miktzat betulim, some of the betulim mashma. V'hava mishtere bogeret, ha tishta dechtiv betuleha. Mitzera bogeret, de mashma de ba'inan kol betuleha. I need the full dam betulim, and a bogeret already starts to go down. Divrei Rabbi Meir, Rabbi Leizer, Rabbi Shimon, machshirim bebogeret. They say a bogeret is okay. Be'maika mifligi, how does this machloka work? How can it be? Says Gemara, Rabbi Meir savar, Rabbi Meir holds, betula afilu miktzat betulim. Betula alone implies some betulim. As long as you have some betulim, you consider betula. Right? Afilu miktzat betulim mashma. Betuleha, when it says her betulim, so that's changing it. You're going from some of the betulim to all her betulim. Right? Ad ika kola betulim. Bivtuleha, the extra bit, comes b'kedarka in shelo kedarka lo. It's another Rashi. Bivtuleha, bet yetera, demashma hachi, lemidrash kom betulim. She's only asur if the bi'ah happened in the place where betulim is, which is in the front. Da'ainu kedarka, im niv'ala nifsela l'kohen gadol. She was nevala l'kedarka, she's pasul to the Kohen Gadol. Aval bebe'ila shelo l'kedarka, if the bia happened, shelo kedarka, na b'mkom betulim lo. De lemeisar be'ula shelo kedarka, leke lemeimar mehaikera, u lemidrash ad shiu ko betuleha kayamim, v'afilu shelo kedarka. Why don't you say biftuleha, if until all the betulim is kayamim, ben kedarka, ben shelo kedarka, and who says such a dirasha kedarshina la aliba dribiliazar? Why? I can't do that. Kivan de betula mema'et bogeret. Since betula already was mema'et, betuleha, sorry, that I need all her betulim. So at that point I would have said, ben kedarka, ben shelo kedarka. So what do you bring me another mi'ut for? Right? Koshken be'ula shelo kedarka. Hilka. I mean, which is a bigger pigam? The fact that she lost some of the betulim naturally, or the fact that somebody was with her shelo kedarka? You would say shelo kedarka, right? So therefore, hilkach ki atakra, when the Torah came and said bibtuleha another mi'ut, lemishle ata, must be coming to be matik, because there's no place hiding. Once he said bituleha, bituleha is going to include everything. Everything is asur. Now you say bibtuleha must be coming to minimize that, because I can't go further. Must be coming to go back and to say, Miktzat betuli, I call betulim bimkom betulim, but shelo bimkom betulim and shelo kedarka, that's mutar. That's Rabbi Meir. Biftuleha bekedarka in shelo kedarka lo. So Rabbi Meir has a humrah that you need, that bogeret is no good, and he has a kula that bogeret is no good. No, sorry. The chumrah that bogeret is no good, and the kula that shalobim ko shalok darka is kasher. The Rabbi Lazav, Rabbi Shimon Savri, betula shelema mashma. The betula is a betula shelema. Betula shelema mashma. Betuleha. Vafilu miktzat betulim. They say betula means full betulim. Biftuleha, her betulim, takes it down. Even if you don't have the full thing, it's okay. What do you mean not the full thing? Bogeret is okay. Biftuleha. Ad shiu ko betuleha kayamim ben kedarka ben shelo kedarka. So it comes out, they start the opposite. They start at full. Betuleha says, well, part of it is okay. Whatever she has, as long as it's some betulim. And you might have said at that point, even shelo kedarka is okay. Biftuleha, shelo kedarka is no good. Only bogeret is good. Rashi. Rabbi Lazav, Rabbi Shimon Savri, I have a ketiv betula shelema mashma. Betula means full. Umitzera bogeret. The bogeret will be asura because she doesn't have a full betulim. Hashta dechriv betuleha, when it says betuleha, afilu miktzat betuli mashma. Lerabot bogeret, it's coming to include bogeret. Bivtuleha, bet yetera, mashma shethe, bivtuleha, shelo ivda mehem kluma yede beila. She didn't lose any betulim through a bi'ah. Ben bekedarka, ben shelo kedarka. Rekivad et rabbi bogeret, since we included a bogeret, lehetera, it's the rich lemesar be'ula shelo kedarka. I had to take out be'ula shelo kedarka. So that's the machloket. Again, the Chachamim, the Rebbe and Bishimon, they have a humra and a kula. The kula is that bogeret is okay, and the kula, that's the kula. The humra is shelokid darka is no good. Amar Rav, nivala shelokid darka. If she had a bi'ah shelokid darka, pesula lekehuna. She's pasul lekehuna. Who, when, where? Rashi. Pesula lekehuna lekohen gadol shemetzuveh ala betula. Since he has to have a betula, if she had a bi'ah shelo kedarka, she's not a betula anymore. Aval lehediot, but to a kohen hediot, filu kedarka kesherah. Even if she had bi'ah kedarka, she's kasher. Ve'en zona, like we said, ela hanivela leasula, someone that she wasn't allowed to marry. But if she had bi'ah with a plain old guy, she wouldn't be asura. Mativ rava. So even though he calls kehuna, which sounds like regular kohanim, he means to the kohen, kohen gadol. Mativ Rava, Rava asked the question. Velo tehiye leisha. To you, according to Rav, any betula on the bottom of Nutet, any betula, even if she had a bi'ah shelo kedarka, is asur to the kohen gadol. Any bi'ah in a betula makes a pasul to the kohen gadol. Mativ Rava, velo tehiye leisha. Right, that's talking. A guy that is mefateh, he seduces a betula, unmarried. The Torah says he has to marry her. V'lo tehiye l'isha, right? So we doresh b'isha ha'uyala. The chiyuv of marrying her is only if he's allowed to marry her. Prat le'almana le'kohen gadol. But if this kohen gadol raped an almana, not raped, he seduced an almana who's a betula, an ara betula. Or a kohen idiot seduced a girushava halutza, the kohen idiot, since he can't marry her, he has to go with option B, which is pay the money, pay the knas. Says the Gemara, Rashi, prat la almana mina erusin. This almana that the kohen gadol seduced, she was only engaged. She never made nisuim, so she's still a betula. Vezeh me'anes, unfortunately, was the kohen gadol who, or girusha, or halutza mena erusin he, or she's a girusha halutza also from erusin, so she's still a betula because the chiyuv of mefateh to marry her is only if she's a betula. Im kohen edyoti. So now says Gemara, hey chidami, what's the case? What's the case that the reason why the Kohen Gadol can't marry her is because she's an almana? How did he mefateh her? Ilema bekedarka. If he had to be out with her kedarka the regular way, right? My iria mishum almana. What's the difference that he can't marry her because she's an almana? He can't marry her because she's a betula. She's a be'ula. No, it's not Azur.
She was an almana.
Great. So almana, first of all, that's a question. Does the Kohen Gadol with the almana posel her if he didn't marry her? That's a question. But regardless of that, the almana is causing the zonah. But if you're telling me that a bi'ah kedarka, that a bi'ah shelo kedarka also makes a pasul, so either way he was with her, she's already considered a bi'ula. So even if she wasn't an almana, he couldn't marry her. If you hold that bi'ah shelo kedarka does not make her a bi'ula, so you'll say, if he would have slept with a girl shelo kedarka who's not an almana, marry her. Why? She's not a bi'ula. Veloti l'isha, go marry her. But if he slept with a kedarka, then she became a bi'ula, and he can't marry her, even though she's not an almana. So when do you have the case that the reason why the Kohen Gadol can't marry her is only because she's an almana, is when he was with her. Shelo kedarka. Shelo kedarka didn't make her a be'ula, but she's already an almana. He can't marry her. Whether she became a zona or not is a separate issue. Right? Right. Again, hey chidami, ilayme bekidarka. If the biyah was kidarka, tepuklei my iria mishum amana. What? Why are you telling me that he can't marry her because she's an amana? Tepuklei mishum dahavi ala beula. She became a beula as soon as he was mefateha. Rashi, tepuklei. Rashi says it's biyat ones.
So there's two cases.
This is not mefateh. Sorry, this is ones. He raped her. Upset. Tepuklei dahav le be'ula. She's a be'ula. V'tanya lekaman. We learned later. Anusat atzmo umufutat atzmo lo yusa. He cannot even marry his own, the girl that he raped himself.
No, she says.
Because she's a be'ula. You might have thought that he has to marry a be'ula, not be'ula from someone else. But if he was the perpetrator, then maybe he could. What's it called? Maybe he can marry his own. Clean up your own mess. The one that says even Be'ulat that's more he can't marry. His Be'yah has to be Be'kiddushin. Says Gemara, El Alav, Shelo Kedarka. Must be that the Be'yah that he had with her, the Ones, was Shelo Kedarka. And therefore he's only Asur and her Mishum Almana I Mishum Be'ulah Lo. And you, Rav, you're saying that if somebody is with a lady, Shelo Kedarka, she's not allowed to marry Kohen Gadol. How are you going to explain this Mishnah? Says the Gemara, Hamani Rabbi Meir. No problem. That Mishnah goes like Rabbi Meir. Rabbi Meir, we just said, holds that Bi'ah Shelo Kedarka is not posel Isha LeKohen Gadol. Verav de Amar Kerabi Lazar. Rav, who said that he can't marry, a Kohen Gadol can't marry Niv'ala Shelo Kedarka, he's going like Rabbi Lazar, who said Bogeret is okay, Bi'ah Shelo Kedarka is not. Rashi. Hamani Rabbi Meir de Amar Betuleha Ad Shuko Betuleha Kayamim Biftuleh Chabi. Prat Le Bogeret. Oh, sorry. Betuleha. My mistake. Ad Shuko Betuleha Kayamim Prat Le Bogeret. The Aitar le bibtulea le me'ote be'ula shelo kedarka. Deshari, he's matir be'ula shelo kedarka. The Rav de Amar pesula, Rav that says that she's pesula. Second line, right? Now third line. Ked Rabbi Lazar, like Rabbi Lazar, the Amar le'el bibtuleha miktzat bibtulim. Le rabuye bogeret, the ata bibtuleha le me'ote be'ula shelo kedarka shdele'el. He holds like Rabbi Lazar. Says Gemara, Iker Rabbi Lazar. Rabbi Lazar himself has a peculiar shita, very unique. My iria mishum be'ula. Why is she only asu? Because she was niv'ala shelo kedarka. Tepuklei tahav yelazona. Rabbi Lazar holds that a lady that had a bi'at zenut, a bi'at without kiddushin, already becomes a zona. We hold not like Rabbi Lazar that in order to be a zona, you have to be a bi'ah to someone that she's not allowed to marry. But Rabbi Lazar holds, not she's not allowed to marry. She's not married. If she's not married, she's called a zona. Yeah. All the bi'ot pesulot are even be'onis. Says the Gemara.
Yeah.
So
when you had she had no choice.
Right, so she can't marry the Kohen.
But she's not
confused. Yes, she is. Esther for sure is a zona, according to everybody. She slept with a goy. Every life entails sacrifice. Sometimes it's, but it doesn't mean it's not, she's not great, but she was with a goy, she's pasul kiluna. That won't be her thing. She won't marry the Kohen Gadol. Amar Bilazar. The Ha'amar Bilazar Panui, an unmarried man. Haba'ala Pinuya, who's with an unmarried lady. Shelo L'shem Ishut, if it's not a Bi'av Kedushin. Asa Azona, he made her a Zona. So what's Rav's case that he says that he says Nivala shelo kedarka is asura lekohena to kohen gadol because of betula. In that case, she's going to be asur to every kohen. And you tell me, oh, I'm holding like Rabbi Lazar. Says according to Rabbi Lazar, it's going to be asur to every kohen because of zonah. Says Gemara. Now, you could have said that Rav holds like Rabbi Lazar that you need that Shiloket Darkah is posel, and he disagrees with him about Panuya Baal Panuya Azona. Right? I hold like this position, I don't hold like that position. But Tosafot says, V'Rav de Amar Kerebi Lazar, Moshes Savar Rav Kerebi Lazar. He doesn't hold like him. Dahar Rav Ushmuel de Amri Tarvayu. Bogeret umukat etz lo yisa. They both say that a Kohen Gadol cannot marry a Bogeret. That means that he holds like Rabbi Meir. And if you can't marry a Bogeret, you can marry Shiloket Darkah. If you could marry a Bogeret, you can't marry Shiloket Darkah. They're two sides of the same coin. So what do you have to say? You have to say Rav's statement was according to Rabbi Elazar. Not that I hold like Rabbi Lazar. The statement that I made to explain the shita of Rabbi Lazar. Oh, you're explaining his shita, then I don't understand why you need bi'ah shalot kedarka for Kohen Gadol. She should be a zonah for all Kohanim. Now, put on your seatbelt. Says Gemara, Amar Rav Yosef, we're talking kegon shenev ala lebehema. This bi'ah shalot kedarka that she had wasn't with a human. It was with an animal. And that surprisingly, does not make her a zona. Yes, be a lebehema. Says Gemara, right? Mishum be'ula ika, she's a be'ula. Mishum zona leka, but she's not considered a zona.
Is there a different term for her, or she's just not a zona?
She's a be'ula, but she can marry a kohen idiot. Amar le Abaye, Abaye says, Miman of Shach. How could it be? I be'ula havya, if she's a be'ula. Zona nami havya. She should be a zona. If it's a bi'ah, then she's a zona. It's not an, she can't marry the animal. V'i zona lo havya. If she's not a zona, why? Because it's not a bi'ah. Be'ula nami lo havya. Not a bi'ah. How could it be a bi'ah and not a zinu? Jimmy started off. It's not a bi'ah, but it is a bi'ah. You can't be one and not the other. Rashi, izona lohavia. If you're not considering a zona, imken lav bi'ah. It must be it's not a bi'ah. Filu kohen gadol tishdiri. Says the Gemara, v'chi teima midi dehave amukat etz shelo kedarka. So no, we say mukat etz. If she got the bitulim were knocked out mechanically, right? Something happened. She fell. She lost the bitulim. That's called mukat etz. And this lady, although it's not a bi'ah, it's like a mechanical bi'ah shelo kedarka. The behemah is not considered a bi'ah. Whatever reason, it's not a bi'ah. Fine. It's the same as taking a stick, using a stick. So it's not a bi'ah. It's a stick. Just like a stick could be posel or kidarka because it knocks out the bitulim. Maybe a stick could be posel because it's like a bi'ah shelo kidarka. Rashi, v'chita imamidi deha ve'amukat etz. Deha Rabbi Elazar ka'amar b'matniti lo yisad mukat etz. He doesn't allow her to marry mukat etz. V'tibai lemeima, and you'll say, da'afilu b'mukat etz shelo kidarka pisula, that a mukat etz shelo kidarka is no good. Imken, if that's the case, we're suggesting maybe it's such an issue. Imken, en lecha isha shekeshira lekihuna shelo naasid mukat etz al yedei tzeror. He's every lady. In those days, Charmin wasn't invented yet. They used to use rocks to clean themselves. So every lady's a mukat etz shelo kedarka. Hopefully, if she cleaned herself. Rashi. Imken, en lecha isha shekeshira lekihuna gedula shelo naasi mukat etz al yedei tzeror shel kinuach bet hakiseh. Ela, Amar Bizera. What? Because only Keuna Gedola is an issue of Mukatez. Ela, Amar Bizera, Bemema Enet. I'll tell you the case. This girl was a Ketana. Her father died. Her mother married her off to so and so, right? And he only had with her Biashelo Kedarka. As a Ketana. And then she walked out on him. So the Bi'ah was not Bi'ah Zinu, because it's within the framework of a marriage, right? And she was never Niv'ala Kedarka. So Rav is telling you she's Keshera for a Kehuna because it's not a Bi'ah Zinu, but she's Pesula to the Kohen Gadol because he also, in the Shitav Rabbi Lazar, Ben Bekedarka, Ben Shelo Kedarka. Rashi Ela Amar Bizera Mashkaha La Laha De Rav. Aliba de Rabbi Lazar, the Havya Be'ula Velozona, Velo Almana, Velo Girusha, hell, the Ketana Yetoma, and he said, Le Baal, she got married, Ubaala, Shiloke Darka, he was with her only Shiloke Darka, Umianabo, maybe that's why she walked out on him. The end comes to Zenut. There's no Zenut. The Almanut, the Girushin, the Ashwin and Rav, the Yesh comes to Be'ula Le Kohen Gadol. Amar Rav Simi Bar Chiya. It's not a marriage. As when she walks out, it's like they were never married. Right. Not only minor, because the marriage wasn't a Doraita marriage. The father didn't make it. The mother made it. Mother doesn't. Not, mother's not legally empowered from the Torah. Only Midrabanan. Amar Rav Simi Bar Chiya. Niv'ala lebehema keshera lekihuna. A lady who was with an animal is kasher to marry a kohen, and we don't consider her a zona, even if she was married. Well, let's see, kasher lekuna afilo lekohen gadol. She could even marry a kohen gadol. The mukat etz be'almahi. It's a regular mukat etz. Uman de shari be mukat etz shari ba. Whoever's matir mukat etz, Rabbi Meir would be matir that. Tanyana mihachi, niv'ala lemi she'enu ish, if she was with someone who's not a man, afal pisha b'sikila, even though she's chayav sikila, like it says in the Torah, keshera lekehuna, she can marry a kohen. Rashi, lemi she'enu ish behema, afal pisha b'sikila, im yesh edim v'atra, if they warned her, heichadaleka edim v'atra, if there were no edim or there was no atra, keshera lekehuna, she can marry a kohen. Ki ata Rav Dimi, when Rav Dimi came, Amar ma'ase beriva ahab behitlu. There was a story with a young girl in a place called Hitlu. Shaita mechabedet et habayit. She was cleaning the house. Ve'reva'a kelev kofri me'ahoreha. And a large dog mounted her from behind. Rashi shelo kedarka. And Rabbi told her she can marry a kohen. Amar Shmuel ule kohen gadol. Sorry, lekehuna. Rabbi said she can marry. She can marry a kohen gadol. Because what's the question? Question is, Shemaria is considered be after Kohen Gadol, like we said before. Amale Shmuel, Ul Kohen Gadol, Bimei Rebbe, Amale Shmuel, Amale Shmuel, come on. Rebbe was Matir, Machshir for Kohen Gadol. Says the Gemara, Bimei Rebbe, Kohen Gadol, Mihave, was there a Kohen Gadol in the time of Rebbe? Ela, what he said was, Ru Yalo Kohen Gadol. She's Ra'oi for a Kohen Gadol if there'll be one. Amale Rava Mi Pirkin, ומפרזיקה לרב אשי. מנה המלטה דאמור רבנן אין זינו לבהמה. Where did the rabbis learn that a lady with a behema, even though it's listed in the arayot, it's not considered zinut? דכתיב, it says like this. לא תביא את נן זונה ומחיר כלב. Don't bring the price paid to a zonah, or the price something that you paid for a dog with. Bet Hashem Elokecha. They both pasul for korban. What? Very good. Right? Vetanan, etanan kelev, umchir zona mutarim. Let's say you don't have the money that you paid the zona to be with her. You have the money that you paid to the dog to be with him, or the dog to be with her. No. Or you have mihir zona. You bought a zona. Exactly. Right? Rashi. Etanan kelev. Shem amar adam lezona. Heilach taleze. Take this sheep. The ba'ali lekelbi. And sleep with my kelev. Or mihir zona. Shechliv zona betale. He owned a shivcha who was his zona, and he switched her for a tale. Mutarim la mizbeach. Umid deshari etanan kelev. Since we allow etanan is always the money paid for bi'ah. Since we allow mehir etanan kelev, alma lav zinutu. You see, it's not considered zinut because zona is asur. If we matir etanan kelev, it's not considered zinut. It's considered kelev, not zinut. How do I know that those two are mutar? Maybe it's switch, both of them are asur. Shene'emar gam shene'em. Also the two of them. Shnaim velo arba. Two and not four. Tanu Rabbanan. Anusat atzmo. If he raped her. Umefutat atzmo. Or if he seduced her. Lo yisa. He can't marry her. The Kohen Gadol. V'im nasa nasui. But if he married her, he could stay married. Or he's married. Anusat atzmo. Anusat havero, if somebody else raped her. Umefutat havero. And somebody else seduced her before. Lo yisa. The Kohen Gadol can't marry her. V'im nasa. But if he married her, the Bileza ben Yaakov omer havlat halal. The Bileza ben Yaakov says, the child is a halal like if he married an almana. V'chachamim omrim havlat kasher. The vlad is kasher, but everybody agrees that he's not nasui. Okay. Baruch Adonai le'olam. Amen ve'amen.
What do you mean? Wow. You did good today.